I also intend for this to be a commentary practice run. Maybe on the quieter side, but I will be trying to talk as I play. Alright, so welcome everyone. My name is davidtki. I'm going to be playing Mage's Initiation, Reign of the Elements, for a side quest, Questing for Glory Tale, next week. This was a kickstarted game released in 2019 by Himalaya Studios, which is the same group that did the fan remakes of King's Quests 1, 2, 3, and Quest for Glory 2, although they did that under a different name. So this game allows you to play as the mage, in training, Dark, who is finally going to be initiated. And during the game, you can pick one of the four classical elements to play as. For this game, I'm going to be playing as the Water Mage, because water is the classical element that I most identify with, and it's the only one I've played so far. So, first things first, the game offers the icon bar, which is your traditional Sierra fare, but there's also a verb coin, which is going to be familiar to anybody who's played Full Throttle. There's also this compact interface, which kind of does the verb coin, but smaller, I think. Anyways, timing starts when I click icon bar, so 3, 2, 1, go. So you're going to see some stuff that looks like HE speedruns, because if you hold escape, then you can rapidly teleport across the screen. So first things first, I need to go to this hallowed hall. The combination is always water, air, earth, and they're going to give me a quiz to try to determine which element that I most identify with. You answer the questions right, and you're going to become a water mage. And now I'm in my water mage robes. So I need to collect a few things around the mage tower before I'm ready to go out on my journey, which basically they want me to collect three things and bring them back. It's light, air. I still have to look at my notes for this. So there's a handkerchief here that I'm going to need, but I'm also going to need to talk to Jonas here and ask to look into his telescope, where I'm going to look at the Fortress of the Priestess, and I'm going to find that I can't see it very well because it's got an illusion on it. So I'm next going to go to the Fountain Hall, pick up a seashell there. I also need to pick up some mage's water from the fountain. It's an ingredient in a spell that I'm going to need later. And so this water mage will tell me that there ought to be a book about illusions. So I'll go back to the library here to talk to my friend Bort. He's the librarian. And I ask about a transparent fluidity book. It's important that I read this book because it's going to tell me a recipe for a spell that breaks illusions. And I already know this recipe, but Dark won't know to ask for one of the ingredients unless he has seen the book. Finally, we go to the training room. Don't forget to get this metal pole here, and then talk to the sphere here to get your first spells. But it's going to give you a riddle, which the answer is the seashell I picked up earlier. And then it gives you the first couple of spells. Then this guy gives you a conductor, which will allow you to channel some spells into combat. And then he tells you to get this gemstone from the table and go ahead and equip it in your conductor. And then basic combat. My first basic spell is an ice shard, and the second spell is a shield that makes enemies unable to see me. But I don't need to train more combat than that right now. And finally, go to the Mage's Tower exterior. So we're going to be going around and picking up a few things. The first important thing I need to do is I need to be going to various screens and picking up planks, rope, pretty much anything I need to make a raft. There's four planks, a piece of rope. There's a plank right here, an oar here, which I use to get the oar out in the water, and then leave here. But I also need to collect ingredients for that transparent fluidity potion, One of them is sap from this tree, and I don't know to ask him about the sap unless I've read that book. But he won't let me get the sap unless I recover some of his fruits. So, one of the things I'll need to do to get his fruit back, because he told me a girl in town took it, she won't give me the fruit back. I took her wrong turn there. She won't give me the fruit back unless I give her some other valuable fruit in exchange. Luckily, there happens to be some in the forest here that I will spray with some water and then knock it down. By the way, get used to that jet stream spell. It's one of my most basic spells, but you're going to see it a lot. It's a non-combat spell. You just spray water at something really quite useful in a lot of places. I went too far again. Let's see. There's more planks this way. I'm gonna be collecting some stuff for the second task later. There's ants on this bush. I spray them with water to get them to go away, and then I grab some berries. I'm gonna need that for the second, right? The metal pole I grabbed in the training room, I need to use it to loosen this plank here. This is going to be the last plank I need. Then a couple screens over here, there are some wasps here, and I can't do anything now, but I have to see those wasps before I can ask an expert how to deal with them. Finally, we can go to town. This guy's got some stuff to trade. I'm going to need 3 flasks and a bandage. I'll need a lot more potions later, but I don't have the money for that right now. There's a couple of these guys in the tavern. They'll be important later, but for now, one of the ingredients for the transparent fluidity potion is a very strong ale. Unfortunately, Dark is only 16, so he's not going to be sold a very strong ale. This guy's drinking a very strong ale, though, and he's inebriated enough that he won't notice me switching it out. Need 2 barrels for flotation devices. This is the girl who took the screaming tree fruit, and she won't give me his fruit back unless I give her the fruit I found in the forest. Then I also need to see the blacksmith. Sweat is one of the ingredients for the transparent fluidity potion, so I give him the handkerchief so he can wipe himself, and that's kind of gross, but I also need his help to put these planks together. 5 coins is the minimum that he's willing to take to hammer them together. One of the things that I often forget here is to actually visit the screaming tree again to get what I need from him. So, gotta do that right now. Give him back the fruit that he lost, and then he's gonna tell me, yeah, take as much. You can take some sap. So, use one of those empty flasks to take some sap. And then I can mix together my transparent fluidity potion, which is Mage's Water, Strong Ale, and Sweat. And so now I'm finally ready to go to the fortress on that island to get a lock of the priestess's hair, because that's my task. Gotta tie the barrels to the raft, put the raft on the river, and then go out. But then we've got a little maze puzzle here. Somebody at the tower was... I was supposed to ask for help, and they were going to give me a compass and then a poem that would pretty much tell me the way through this water, but the solution is the same every time, so I don't need to do that. And then we finally get ourselves to the island. You're going to drink that transparent fluidity potion so that you can actually see the fortress. And then you're also going to get a flask of lake water while you're here. The priestess is going to ask for it later, so better to get it before she asks. Then we've got a little bit of a maze here. This maze is actually a little bit dangerous. There's random encounters that can come out, except that I've turned random encounters off. That is an option in this game. We're going to be wandering through the room, collecting these loose tiles on the ground. There's 4 of them. You need all 4. And they're in the same place every time. And then finally, we're gonna go see the priestess herself, who happens to be right here, and I'm gonna tell her, well, she was imprisoned for doing dark magic some time ago, but I'm gonna be like, hey, I need your help to get your hair. And she's gonna be like, I don't just give my hair away, boy, but fine. I have a treasury with a dagger, and you have to actually talk to her first before this room opens up to you, where you then stick all these tiles in. It's pretty obvious where they go. And then we're going to end up in the treasury and have some weird puzzle that we got to deal with. So first of all, we have to open up a way to the mirror world. First things first, we will need this strange device to escape. Then we've got a puzzle coming up, which is RNG. The prince's heart. So there's four different tales that could show up in that book. Wait, is it this thing? Yeah, I haven't seen this one for a while. But you gotta activate this thing on different thing, and the tail in the book tells you what you need to activate. But there's four possible tails. I have them written down. You open up a mirror, which puts you in a weird mirror dimension where you have somehow become a fire mage. How odd is that? But the mirror world is where you can actually get the dagger. The chest, when opened here, doesn't have anything in it. The strange device I picked up is missing that thing, and you gotta put it in here, in the mirror world, but you can't explore the mirror world. Dark wants to be in his own world, where he's rightfully a water mage. Ah, but the chest is open here now, grab that, and now we can leave. So now we have the priestess's dagger, the only thing that can cut her hair. And so we're gonna show her the dagger, but and she's gonna say, I also need lake water, but I already grabbed that earlier. And so we offer her the lake water, but then suddenly she does some magic, has us imprisoned, and is gonna do something to escape somehow. But first she does the classic Bond villain mistake of leaving us alone, and then which allows us to do something to get out of these chains, which is gonna be a basic water spell, the most basic water spell of all. You know, you would think that she'd do something to strengthen those chains, especially considering that she's a former water mage. I don't know. Oh, but there's a lock on the door, and so I'm gonna use this executioner device or something to break that lock. So you might have noticed the plus in the lower left. I do have stats, and I've gotten enough XP to actually assign stuff to my stats. Oh, better equip this thing that I got. And I gotta go ahead and assign XP because I've got battle coming up. So, I've got four stats. Strength is how much damage my spells do, intelligence is how accurate my spells are, and then there's also magic, which is how many mana points I have, and vitality, which is how much HP I have. You generally want to dump your points equally into strength and intelligence. But you can't neglect vitality and magic completely either. Anyways, you kill the familiar, and that makes the battle super easy. Grab the dagger, only thing that can cut her hair, and then you cut her hair, and yay, we've done the first task. We've got the priestess's hair. But we have an option available to us now to decide whether to kill or spare the priestess. She's gonna collapse. You're gonna spare the priestess. You get more experience for it, and you get a bonus intelligence point every time. So, always spare. I also picked up a gem from that, from the stone crab monster. That's gonna be important. And so, with the first task completed, I'm gonna go back to the mage's tower to report my success. Meanwhile, a cutscene's gonna play. There's unrest brewing in the town because the lord, just lounges around in his mansion, decrees lots of stuff, and doesn't do anything. In preparing for the second task, I'm going to come back to the training hall because I'm ready to learn more spells. And it's the sphere of knowledge is going to tell me, use your knowledge to put out this fire here or something like that. And it's going to get me a key which I need to use on something that has never been opened before. So that's going to be the chest in Dark's private hall, which he's never been able to open since he got there. There's a scroll in it, which you show to the Sphere of Knowledge, and it gives you more spells. Alright, so before I go out, I'm going to need some help with a thing. So, the wasps that I saw earlier, I got to ask Jonas about them, and he's going to suggest using some sort of intoxicating fruit to deal with them. But Bort here is going to know more about how to actually use intoxicating fruit to deal with the wasps. And he's going to tell me that I need an incense burner, which this guy has. But he wants me to go get his stuff from the desert, or the wastelands, before he will let me borrow it. And it's right here. There's a new spell that I learned that I'm going to be using a lot. Teleport. Which allows me to teleport to any place with these stone pillars. So I got my incense burner now, but while I'm here, I'm also going to trade this smooth ruby. I'm going to sell. And then I'm going to buy a lot of mana potions and healing potions. Those are going to come in super handy. So Dark's private hall is going to come into use again. The berries I got from the bush with the ants on it, I'm going to grind it up here and then stick it in the incense burner and then light it on fire. And so now I have everything I need to deal with the wasps, because the incense burner with those berries, you're going to put it under here and it's going to put the wasps to sleep. But that just makes them not a threat. They're still there. I'm going to need to spray the wasp nest with water. And for some reason that kills the wasps? I'm not sure how that works. But then I need an empty flask to put these wasps in. And only once I have the empty flask with the wasps will these eagles let me past. But we come here and we find this Flytarian boy has been attacked. Don't forget to take his feathers. You're going to need them. But we're going to help him out. So, first of all, examine his injury and remove the rock fragment. You can do these three things in any order. A bandage that I purchased earlier, I'm going to use it to bandage up his leg. To provide it some support. And I'm going to give him a healing potion to make him feel better. Once you have done all these things, you can then lift him up. Alright, so his story was that he was flying near town, and then he was hit by fire. His dad is really mad at the humans for stealing stuff and being in trouble, and Dark's going to offer his assistance in actually investigating what's going on. But to get further, I'm going to need to get the chief's favor. The chief... Let's see, where am I... I lost my train of thought for a moment. Okay, I'm going to town because the chief is really fascinated with windmills, and so I'm going to make a little tiny windmill. But first I need to borrow this wooden wheel. It's not doing anything. The wagon's broken. And then I'm going to... Let's see, some of my remaining tree sap will be stuck on the feathers. The metal pole goes here. And then I need the blacksmith's help to join the parts together. So, important bit... I'm not going to be teleporting in town. Dark notes that he's not allowed to use magic in town. All the people in town, they don't know how to use magic. Alright, so I can teleport back to the Flytarian Overlook because I have created the windmill that that Chief Hawkane likes. But he's going to be offended if I use his son's feathers without permission, so I'm going to get his son's permission. I do need to go to the valley floor real quick to get this torn paper at the bottom. And then fly back up to Hawkane's porch. So, the thing is that... Dark will not ask this guy to fly him if he could just jump across the ledges. But jumping across ledges is slow, which is why I put the trip to the valley floor below. So I'm investigating some thievery. There's fruits here and scraps of paper in here. And so I'm going to explore this other place where thievery happened. And I'm going to find another torn paper. This fallen candle I'm going to grab for use later. And then I'm actually going to come back here. I have to jump to the other porch to do this, but I gotta light this candle for use later. And so, having done that, I can now teleport back to the Mage's Tower to get to the town. Because some fruit from town was found there, so I'm gonna ask the lady if some of her fruit went missing, and she's gonna say, hey, there was a weird object here, and then I'm gonna go grab that object. So once I have that object, I'm going to show it to Falk to find out more about it. And he's going to say it belongs to somebody named Pecan. So you go there, and you're going to see breadcrumbs on the ground. So the bread guy must have something to do with that. But I've also gotten the fourth piece of a torn poster. The bread guy had a poster here, and it was torn, and he won't give me information until I have replaced every piece of the poster. Once I've done that, he's going to give me a Flytarian comb, which is another clue in the whole thievery thing. So, gotta teleport back. You might notice a pattern. We're going back and forth here. So, naturally, Falk can tell me who this comb belongs to, which is going to be somebody named Parla. She is a grieving widow who recently lost her husband, but a magpie has been visiting her, and she, for some reason, thinks the magpie is her husband. But the magpie has been going around and stealing stuff, and so that's what's really been going on. So the chief has been blaming humans for when in fact a magpie was responsible. But that's not the extent of investigation, because emissaries from the village have failed to talk to the chief in some time. Plus, we did have some fire that was responsible for his son's injury. Anyways, this guard follows the bird to an outcropping over here, and this is going to be a pretty difficult part. There's going to be a mandatory battle here, and this battle is quite difficult. First things first, boost up my stats. So we've got three wraiths here, because they're just looking to surround you and cause you a whole mess of trouble. So we go to the cave entrance here, because that's gonna give me cover from two of them. And then finally this guy comes to the door. But yeah, I can't stress how difficult this battle is until you find a strategy where you get enough cover. It caused me a good amount of problems until I came up with that strategy of using the cave entrance for cover. Unfortunately, this third wraith is pretty difficult to deal with. He starts to heal himself, and you gotta have mana potions, because you can cast your basic attack spell without mana, but it ends up being weaker, and you'll never outdamage the wraith's healing if you're not filling yourself back up with mana. Anyways, I figured out where the missing emissaries are. They're dead. Somebody's responsible for that. But most importantly, I proved that not all humans are bad, and that there's something nefarious going on. So, having done all of that, I finally have permission to go to the griffin nest for the second piece that I've been after the whole time, which is the egg of a griffin. So I can go to the griffin nesting grounds now. We're gonna have a little stealth-based mini game here. The idea is supposed to be dark hides while the griffin is patrolling back and forth, and if the griffin sees me or notices its egg is missing, there's an empty eggshell over here that I can grab. Then the griffin will start to attack. However, if you hold the right buttons, be sure to grab the intact egg. I held the wrong button again. I need to be holding down. Okay. So if the griffin sees you and notices its egg missing, then that avalanche will come and it's going to block your path out. Now, it's not too difficult to just go around the long way, but you do lose some time for it. You lose XP if you do the dishonorable thing and actually attack the griffin, but it will get you off your back for a bit. Now, I could say, hey, I noticed a conductor. There's something weird and some mage is responsible for it, but that takes time. I'm not going to do that. And unrest is brewing further still in town. Oops. I'm ready to get my third set of spells now, and it's going to tell me, go to an empty room and use your talents there. If you type in a random combination on the door, then you're going to end up in this room that's in the middle of nowhere. So, it's going to have a hole in it. You fill it with water, but you don't want to go swimming, so you freeze the water, open up the box, and you got yourself a scroll, which is going to have your third set of spells. So, bring it back to the training hall. Alright, so the third thing I need is the Horn of a Trinicorn, and that's known to be in the Bloodbark Forest somewhere. So, we're back here. A brief bit of history, there are goblins in the forest. There are red goblins and green goblins. They're pretty much like two different tribes. Mages did something to isolate them in the forest a while ago. So this path to the north is going to be open now. It wasn't open before. We see a red goblin trapped here, but then, oh, he takes our griffin egg, and so we're going to have to take him, we're going to have to chase him down to get it back. And no, the stream was not skipping there. I was holding escape to do quick movement again. Unskippable cutscene here.
Seeker of power, your deeds have proven you worthy. All knowledge contained within this sphere is now yours. You will become the...
Just get on with it!
We're on a timer here.
Receive your power.
I am. I am.
You were.
Shoot!
The mightiest of mages.
Alright, small bit here. They took my stuff, and I'm gonna have to find a way to escape from this cell. The walls are made of dirt, so that jet spell, we're gonna be seeing it again. You spray it at the wall enough, and it's gonna turn into mud. Alright, so we're gonna have to be going around the goblin camp a little bit. And avoiding being seen. We can see that Strahd here is going into the barracks, so we don't want to go into the barracks right now. I gotta find my stuff. There's a note here noting that the previous chef left because people kept yelling at him. I also got some cooking grease there. I'm gonna need that. This is Strahd's hut. There's a note here about nefarious plans to summon a demon. I come out, he's going into the kitchen now, so I gotta go into the barracks now. So, remember not to run when you're in here. I've been holding a button that makes me run between screens, but just because it does make Dark's entrance to a screen a little faster if he's running between screens, but you don't want to run in here because running makes lots of noise, and as soon as you run, that guard will wake up and kill you. Use the key, but oh, the hinges are squeaky, so put cooking grease on it. And then you can open this up, and you're going to get a master key. And then I leave, and we see he's going back to the jail cell, which is not a good sign, because that means they're going to discover that I'm missing soon. But But I go in here, the key opens this cabinet, and I find all my stuff is in here. Even my griffin egg, for some reason. The master key will also open this back door, where I'm gonna grab this rug and then put it on the fence so that I'll be able to climb it to escape. But wait, I was in here to get the horn of a trident horn. Well, it turns out there's a large pile of dirt here, but Dark is a little afraid to get his hands dirty. He doesn't want to go digging through it, so we're just gonna spray it with water instead. And then we're gonna find the skeleton of a trident horn. Well, we'll just take the horn. That's the third thing we need. And yay, that's the last thing. We're done with our quest, right? Oh, they've discovered that I'm missing. Oh well, I'm out now. And meanwhile, the unrest in town is finally going to escalate into a full-blown riot, which is bad for certain reasons. Some other fire mage is gonna be trying to use the ensuing riot to become the new fire master and take control. But in the meantime, the green goblins are gonna knock me out and say, "Hey, those red goblins are up to no good. They're gonna summon a demon. Since you imprisoned us here, you mage, you're going to go stop it, and they're going to turn me into a goblin. And I'm going to go there and pose as a goblin, and I'm going to pose as the new cook. Well, in order to pose, I'm going to have to actually cook. So, goblish goulash. Okay. Fox leg. That's a recipe that I am going to have to follow. So far as I know, there are five recipes. I have them all written down, and I'm looking at it. I'm gonna have to figure out how to do this while commenting at the same time. Wait, bird foot? Is that bird leg? Well, let's go with bird leg. I'll update that note later. There's nothing wrong if you mess up the recipe, you just have to start over again. And then they're gonna tell me that I need two more candles for the ritual. And, well, I'm gonna go to town because there happens to be a couple of candles in town. But, I'm still in the form of a goblin, and if the town guard sees me as a goblin, they're gonna shoot me on sight. So I gotta hide behind these boxes here. Wait for this guy to go past. I am making use of the escape key again to accelerate things. I actually have to go a little too far here and then go back to pass more time. Otherwise, I would be waiting a little longer for the guard to show. And he's gone. And so now we're back here, and wait, weren't we supposed to be stopping this summoning? Why are we helping them by getting candles? Well, they have a summoning book, and we're trying to get that book back. And so, look, the summoning book is out now, and they're trying to summon the demon. Oh, but battle is incoming, so now is a good time to spend points again. At this point, I should probably be maxing out strength and intelligence, and so bonus points are gonna be going into magic and vitality after this. So let's do this. Now, the freeze spell will allow me to interrupt the spell, preventing it for good, and all the goblins will scatter, although a couple of the guards will have their heads together enough to actually bother to fight. I've got a new wave spell, and that spell does a lot of damage if it connects. The hail spell doesn't get a lot of usage in certain situations, but anyways, two guards down, and that's easy enough. Oh, yes, me. I can't right now. And so I grab that summoning book, and I'm finally free to leave the forest. And I can finally teleport back to the tower. Wait, why couldn't I do this before? Because I was out of range or something like that. But I gotta figure out what is going on with the mages. And so one of the mages that I suspect, he's no longer here. And so Bort the Librarian here is going to be able to tell me who took out this summoning book. Which is again going to point to the guy I suspect. And so, where is Varner? And he's like, I don't know. But hey, maybe look at this book. It might tell you the combination to his private quarters. A leafless lass. Okay. A... leafless lass. That seems to have done it. Yeah, I think if you try to hold escape through that doorway, then you end up in the middle of nowhere, no matter if you typed the password correctly. Anyways, we're going to find some diary and some notes. And again, it's going to point suspicion to that one guy. But there's a brief mention of some other guy in one of the notes here that you might overlook. And then we're going to see, oh, they're rioting in town. We got to stop it. It's possible for the game to crash here, which is why I'm not holding the escape key. So we're going to go to town now and try to stop that, whoever that mysterious mage is, from making this riot go through. They're going to storm the Lord's manor because they're tired of him lazing around in his bed all day doing nothing. And they have the help of this fire mage, which we think is Varner. And poof, he's going to appear and stop us. But then it's going to turn out it's not Varner, it was Pyres, who was masquerading as Varner or something like that. And he's going to fight us, but our friend Bort is going to throw a rock at him. Alright, good night, Tikhon. Alright, Bort's going to hold him off while I try to figure out where Varner actually is, because Varner is still missing. So I've got a little pendant now which will help me find him. It's in the upper right here. It will pulse faster the closer I get to Varner. I think it's in this middle section, actually. This must be around here somewhere. There it is. It can be tricky sometimes to see where that thing is trying to lead you. But there's this firebox here that's draining power from Varner. So stick it in a barrel of water to disarm it. How does that work? I don't know. But yeah, it was sapping his power, and so now with it gone, he can get up again and try to deal with the other fire mage. But in the meantime, while the two of them are dealing in, I gotta get into the Lord's manor and try to defend him from the riot. So I still have a bit of berry powder from earlier, the thing that put the wasps to sleep. And you know, it's burning it that makes it put people to sleep. So stick it in his pipe, and the guard's gonna fall asleep. And then I'm gonna grab his helmet while he's asleep. and pretend to be a guard. Hey, you, other guard, go to the front. And then there's a loose bar here, and I can move it to get out. Oh, but this door is locked. I can't get in that way, so I guess I'm going to have to spray water at this water wheel to make it rotate that way, and then ride it up somehow. Anyways, that gets me to this window, where the Lord is sleeping right here, Lord McGuile. And he kind of rudely tells me off and says, get the heck out of here, go do something. And so, I come out here to the riot. And I'm going to say, hey, you're all being duped. That other fire mage was lying, and I can prove it by showing that I was in two of the places, the forest and Flytarian territory. But they chased me away anyways. This way, and... oh, I better block the door so they can't get me in here. That chair will do it. Good job, chair. And then I can get out this window. The Lord's door is not blocked, so I'm going to end up in here again. So I'm going to move this closet over so that they can't get in. And he's going to give me a key to the ground floor so that I can find some other way to get to the riot and deal with them once and for all. Ride the wheel down again. Assign the last of my points because final battle time is coming. There's only these two guys left. You might recognize them from the tavern, maybe you don't. So one of them I can get rid of by throwing my bottled up wasp at him. Ah, he's going to run away. He's actually the smarter one because wasps are trouble. And then this guy's going to say, hey, he deserves this. But I'm going to say, you don't have any right to inflict pain. I'm going to be talking him down. And he's like, you know the hardship I've experienced. But Dart points out he's been at the Mage's Tower for 10 years without ever knowing his parents. Or something like that. But then, bonk, door opens outward because we were too loud. Wait, if the door opens outward, how did we block it? Anyways, the riot is dealt with, and our two friends outside have dealt with the rogue fire mage. Yay, it's all over. Wait, no, he duped him. Looks like it's up to me to save the day. So this is the point at which you do really want lots... uh-oh. You do want lots of potions, because this is going to be a tough fight. Oh, that hurt. Like I said, tough fight. You're not going to bother with the hail spell on this guy. He's smart enough to teleport out of the area. Time is on last hit if you can manage it. The wave spell is most likely to do damage. That's time. And that's a PB.
You won't kill me. I've sensed the hunger within you. You've dreamed of greatness, as have I. Of power exceeding even that of the High Masters. It can be yours. I can help you attain it.
You are right.
Dark, no.
Then you accept.
But I have seen what such desires do to others. The Priestess, whose lust for dominance did not abate over 5 centuries. And then there's you. No.
Then
I didn't kill him, I just knocked him out.
Are you what
I think
we
Oh and hi boy.
If either of you are wondering, I'm fine. Take your time.
Ah, poor boy. Maybe I should do Earth Mage next, just so I can be like my friend the librarian.
We all have a beginning. A moment that defines us, shapes us into something new. For some, that moment is painless, unnoticed. For others, it is a sharper turn. One that comes at a cost, a loss. Change is inevitable. I know my beginning. I know where it has taken me. The future becomes history. Some remembered, most not. As I go forward, two things are certain. I am dark. I am a mage.